It's estimated that 100,000 people in the capital rely on food banks every week, and some are even selling their clothes and white goods in their kitchen in order to eat. In the latest of our series, Fixers, where young people investigate issues that matter to them, two men from East London report on their campaign to make sure no one in Tower Hamlets goes hungry.
My name is Shah Rahman, I'm 24 and I live in Wapping.
And my name is Asad Khan, I'm 23 and I live in Poplar.
Our Fixers project is about tackling food poverty in Tower Hamlets, which is one of the poorest boroughs of UK.
We particularly want to target people from black, minority ethnic backgrounds that have cultural and language barriers. Myself and Shah has been working in the community development field.
We come across a lot of people who are living in poverty.
I live in this country 30 years. I work chef. Now the government has stopped my benefits for 2 months. And I don't know how I can put the food in my table. I start to sell my own stuff. I sell fridge, wash machine, and some clothes.
Has there been any days when you've had nothing to eat at all?
The beginning where I stopped my benefits, yeah, for 3 days. If you're hungry, it's very, very bad. Like someone puts a gun in your head.
The area that we live in across the road is Canary Wharf, and yet still we've got this issue of food poverty.
So I grew up in Bangladesh and saw a lot of poverty firsthand. So when I arrived in the UK and saw that those exact things existed here, that was quite a shocking thing to learn.
In London, we've got 40 food banks serving 34,000 individuals. So that roughly equates to about 100,000 people in London are dependent on food banks every week. Children are a key problem here. 4 out of 5 teachers report children coming to school hungry.
Fixers have helped us by producing these T-shirts to raise awareness of food poverty. These T-shirts will be worn by all the volunteers that are part of the project. We particularly wanted to target people from BME backgrounds that have cultural and language barriers. So we've chosen a wide range of volunteers from all different ethnic backgrounds.
Traditionally, a lot of the help that's come through the charity sector has been mainly the Christian churches. And there's a fear from some communities that these groups will be proselytising. There's also a fear of a loss of faith.
We are trying to get the word out there to get some more halal meat.
We're working with Fixers to produce a film. It's all about fact findings in the area and that there is help out there.
We get referrals every single day. This weekend just gone, we had 30... We handed out 35 bags to over 20 different users.
Later on within this year, we're setting up our own food bank. We don't want anyone to go hungry, no matter what their circumstances are.